Topic of this short video is how to get the models you need from your IC vendors. My name is Colin Warwick, Signal Integrity Product Manager for Agilent ESOF EDA. So the agenda is the IC vendor's dilemma, how to share information with you and yet protect their IP. I'll go over the pros and cons of various tools to do this. I'll demonstrate the software for model creators and the model users, and we'll do some summary and resources. So the IC vendor's dilemma is how do they share a simulatable model with you, the prospective OEM customer, to show how the IC will work in your design, and yet they also want to protect their IP. The solution, of course, is encrypted models. You, the OEM, can run the black box, but not see inside the box. For this presentation, I'm going to assume the IC vendor's design is in the form of a textual netlist in the H-SPICE dialect of SPICE. This is the most common case. ADS can actually encrypt other dialects and languages too, and most of the steps are the same. Tech support can walk you through any differences if the design is in some other form. So assuming your vendor's model is an H-SPICE netlist, you have three options to get hold of it, as shown in this table. Unencrypted H-SPICE is our H-SPICE compatibility flow. You can run that in the ADS transient convolution license. This is faster and more flexible than co-simulation. Unfortunately, the IC vendor is probably unwilling to expose the IP in this format. So the second option is the H-SPICE netlist encrypted with Agilent's encryption key. That's what I'll demonstrate today. Again, this is our H-SPICE compatibility flow. Same license and same advantages. The con here is you may have to nudge the IC vendor to encrypt their H-SPICE netlist with the Agilent encryption key. That's the purpose of today's video. There is actually a third option, which is to run the H-SPICE netlist encrypted with Synopsys' encryption key. This is our so-called encrypted SPICE flow. You'll need the ADS transient convolution license and also a Synopsys H-SPICE license because we're going to do co-simulation in this case. The models are widely available already, but you do have the co-simulation overhead, and there are some restrictions in co-simulating with H-SPICE and ADS. For example, Ptolemy is not available. So I strongly recommend this second option, which is what I'll demonstrate today. So these are the steps the IC vendor will go through to get you the models you need. First of all, go to our website, agilent.com, find ESOF support, and go to the Knowledge Center. There you'll find the download section for ADS. On the download page, you'll need three things. One is the binaries for ADS for your platform, the binaries for RFIP encoder for your platform, and this trial license. The IP encoder's got kind of a strange name. It's actually much more general than RF circuitry. It encodes any kind of ADS project. The name's kind of a legacy name. The reason why the binaries are separate is because of export restrictions. So you download those two binaries. Then you fill out this form to get the evaluation license. The ADS installer walks you through the installation procedure, and you have to put the license in the license folder. And then you can fire up ADS and create a new project. I'll give it a name. I'm going to call this one staging, because it's kind of the staging area for our encryption project. I don't need any help for this particular project. So this opens a design window. Just expand that a little bit. I'll go into this tools menu here and pick the H-SPICE compatibility component wizard. I'll browse for my H-SPICE file, wherever it is on the network. I can view the H-SPICE file, make sure I've got the right file here. Give it a name. I'll just call it flip-flop in this case. Now we need to expose some of the nodes in the symbol, and these have to be in numerical order. So I'm going to put these in the correct order, pin 1, pin 2, and so on. Actually, I need to make the VSS is actually pin 3. I'm going to move that up. You can reorder them if you need to. It'll give you some information about the symbol. You can take the default symbol or generate a custom symbol if you want to do some branding. You can put a bitmap on the symbol. I'll just take the default. You can also pass in parameters from the ADS design into the HSPICE netlist. For example, if you have poles and zeros for an equalizer or equalizer settings or something like that. In my case, I don't have any parameters, so I can just leave that blank. And then I'm done. I'll just click finish and drop the symbol into my blank design. Now, normally you could use this symbol as is, but in my case I want to encrypt it. So I have to put ports on the design, and I have to put them on in the order of the pins. So just bear in mind that you start always start top left and work your way around counterclockwise. Just put the pins on and tie these up later. I'm going to rotate these pins, make them neat. So after neating up the pins, we're going to save this, give it a name, maybe the name of the chip part number or something like that will be meaningful. Now we're going to run another tool, the encode design tool. This will close all the windows, so make sure you've saved everything. It opens up this dialog box. We want to encode this design. You can put a bitmap on top of it if you want to do some branding. You can make the DC nodes visible if you like, that's optional. You can do it on a case-by-case basis or globally. Give it a meaningful name, because this will appear in the customer's browser window, and so you don't want it to conflict with other libraries, and also you want it to be easily identifiable. So let's put your company name or something like that. Put some description here. You want to encrypt it as a zip file. Provide your name so we know where the libraries come from. And encode it. The encoding process may take a few seconds. If it's a very large file, it may take several minutes. We have encoded some very large designs, including the Altera Svatix 2 transceiver. So that's actually it. As mentioned in that log file, the design kit's written to this zip file here, and you could distribute that encrypted file to the customers, but I recommend that you do some verification before distribution. I'll show you how to do that now.